Now we are going to discuss what are the criteria required for the aromaticity, or we are going to discuss this Haeckel's rule. Now there are actually four criteria which must be satisfied by the compound to be an aromatic. So if the compound is aromatic, it must satisfy all four criteria. Which are these four criteria? That we are going to discuss in this video. Now, very important point is the molecule must be cyclic. The molecule must be cyclic, just like benzotriene. It must be cyclic, and if it is not cyclic, you can reject that molecule at once, because that compound cannot be an aromatic compound. You can see here in this acyclic compound, there is no bond. There is no overlap between the p orbitals. If this, there is no p orbital, actually each p orbital must able to overlap with either this p orbital or this p orbital from both sides. So if, and it is possible only in the cyclic compound. You can see this acyclic compound, when there is no bond, these two orbitals cannot overlap. There are p orbitals on each carbon. You can see here. So all remaining p orbitals can overlap with either these or these, or either from this side or from that side. But this terminal p orbitals cannot overlap with this, toward this side, because there is no bond. So if the compound is not cyclic, you cannot say that compound is aromatic. So you reject that compound at once. This is most important criteria, or very first criteria. Second is, if the compound is cyclic, this is not actually a complete requirement. So the compound must be cyclic along with planarity. So there must be a plane. All carbon atoms must lie in a one plane. All p orbital must be in one plane. So the compound must be planar. You can see here in benzene ring, all carbons having a p orbitals which are actually aligned, which are exactly parallel with each other, so they can overlap either from this side or from that side, from this side, to form a pi bond. So this is another important point, that the cyclic compound must be planar. You can take here one example, cyclooctatetraene. Cyclooctatetraene. There are four alternate double bonds and each orbital having p orbital. This is cyclic compound, so the first criteria is satisfied. Now what about this planarity? This is not planar compound. This is a tub shaped compound. You can see this tub like structure. And if you consider this tub like structure, you can see here this p orbital lying in this direction and this p orbital lying in this direction. That means these two p orbitals are not aligned. They are not exactly parallel. So you cannot have this pi bond here. You cannot form this pi bond here. So adjacent p orbital cannot overlap. And if overlapping is not there, it cannot form pi bond. And if it is not forming pi bond from both sides, if it is not able to form pi bond from both sides, because it can form bond from this side bilateral overlapping. But this overlapping is not possible. That means it cannot form bond this side. So what is required? Each p orbital must able to overlap with another p orbital from either of the sides, either with this p orbital or with this p orbital. This is not possible here in this case of cyclooctatetraene, because of this shape. This is tub shaped. This is not planar. And if it is not planar, you can reject this molecule. This molecule is not aromatic compound. So it can give addition reaction. It can give addition reaction so easily. It, instead of substitution reaction, it gives addition reaction. So it is, again, we can say this cyclooctatetraene is not aromatic compound. Third criteria is a molecule must be completely conjugated. Now see the meaning of conjugation. Conjugation means the molecule must have alternate double and single bond. You can see here, double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond. So this is called conjugation, which is available in benzene. So this is this kind of conjugation must be there in the molecule. But here in cyclohexadiene, you can see here up to this double bond, pi bond, double bond, single bond. But here, what about these two, this atom? There is no double bond. So this type of conjugation is not observed here in cyclohexadiene. So this is not aromatic. Here also in cycloheptatriene, you can see double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond, single bond. So here at this carbon, there is no conjugation. But remaining all other six carbon, there is conjugation. But still this compound is not aromatic. So the molecule is not having complete conjugation. In another language, we can say all atoms of the ring, listen carefully, all atoms of the ring must have p orbital. So the conjugation means there must be p orbital present on each atom, on each carbon. You can see p orbital is there on each carbon. Here is p orbital. You can see here is p orbital, p orbital, p orbital, p orbital. But there is no p orbital. So two carbons missing p orbital. Because of this, it is not called complete conjugation. You can see here p orbital, p orbital, p, p, p and p. But here, which I have shown using this arrow, there is no p orbital. If one carbon, even one carbon is not having p orbital, then you cannot say that molecule is completely conjugated. And you can reject that molecule and you can say these two molecules are not aromatic because there is no p orbital on certain atoms. So that is the meaning of conjugation. Now, the molecule must satisfy Hockel's rule. This rule is important. So the final and most important criteria is the molecule must satisfy Hockel's rule. What is that Hockel's rule? It must have 4n plus 2 pi electron. So if you put the value of n, that is 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on, so you will get all these numbers. So the molecule must have either 2 pi electron, 6 pi electron, 10 pi electrons, 14 pi electrons and calculation going on, 18 pi electrons and so on. So that molecule is aromatic. So according to this rule, if molecule having 4n plus 2 pi electron, that means 2 pi electron, 6 pi electron, 10 pi electron, 14 pi electron is aromatic compound. You can consider here benzene. You can see here benzene. In benzene there are 6 pi electrons. That means this benzene satisfies this Hockel rule. So this Hockel rule is satisfied by the benzene. So because of this, this is aromatic. You can take one more example of naphthalene. Naphthalene, see here, in naphthalene there are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, means 10 pi electrons. If naphthalene having 10 pi electron, you can see in the list, this is the compound. So this is again satisfying Hockel's rule. This Hockel's rule is satisfied by this naphthalene. So the naphthalene must be aromatic. So important point is what? The molecule must satisfy all four criteria. Which are these four criteria? This must be cyclic, molecule must be planar, there must be complete conjugation. You can write here complete conjugation, and it must satisfy or it must have either 2 pi or 6 pi or 10 pi or 14 pi or 18 pi electrons. So there must be this kind of, this pi system should be there. Then and then only that molecule is aromatic. So that molecule is aromatic. So these are the four criteria which we can apply for the molecules and decide whether the molecule is aromatic or not. If the molecule is aromatic, it shows certain characteristics. The stability and the substitution reaction, burns with sooty flame and so on. One more point I want to add in this video, that the molecule having 4n pi electrons, another rule. So the molecule having 4n pi electrons are actually unstable, molecules, and these molecules are called anti-aromatic molecules. These molecules are anti-aromatic molecules. So if the molecule having 4n plus 2 pi electron molecule is very stable and that molecule is aromatic, so aromatic molecules are more stable.
But if the molecule having 4n pi electrons, that molecule is unstable. And that molecule is called anti-aromatic molecule. So we have seen two terms. One is aromatic, and how to decide whether the molecule is aromatic. And another is anti-aromatic molecule. So we can apply this rule, 4n pi electrons. So if 4n pi electrons along with three other criteria, that molecule is anti-aromatic. And anti-aromatic molecules are unstable. They are less stable or they are unstable as compared to aromatic molecule. So this is all about aromatic molecules and anti-aromatic molecules.